Let's move straight on and hear from Martin Danowski, who's the chairman of the State Agency for Research and Innovation. Mr. Danowski, your reflections, please.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Ross. I hope everything it's okay with the connection. I will try to give you in a few minutes the perspective of the more systematic approach that we are going to take toward the R&I system in Bulgaria, and especially in the role of putting the Bulgarian economy to leap to the new level of the economic transformation, which for us is very essential as we've got these introductory words by the Minister of Economy. So I will start with a few challenges very briefly, because not because most of them are not recognizable by the audience, but because they are very typical for Bulgaria. And the first one of this challenge is the fragmentation, relative fragmentation of the public research infrastructure and the science base, which we realized recently in the last years, and which is one of the challenges that we have overcome working for the reforming all this sector. The second challenge is the collaboration and the way how the science and the business works together, which is not leading it to the appropriate level of the commercialization opportunities. The third one challenge is the insufficient efforts and abilities to have a good financial engineering and to swim better in this whole sea and ocean of the possibilities that even one of them will talk together about the recovery and resilience plan. So I will not even mention the main challenges related to the human resources and the capacity of the human skills part, not only for Bulgarian landscape, but mostly for the Central Eastern Europe at overall. So all these challenges, at least, they are putting us in the position to be a followers, to be even on the lowest, some of the lowest score, unfortunately, and lagging behind the EU average parameters in some of the scoreboards in the R&I ecosystem. So, well, it's not too complaining, but we've just realizing that we've decided to put a strategic approach for our efforts from now on in the next 10 years at least, putting together a couple of instruments to working together: the ESIF funds, the recovery and resilience funds, the Green Deal funds, the national budget financing, and this strategic approach has to lead in fact to address the holy triangle of education, business, and science at the very core, to tackle the problems at the very at some of the very core. And where is it this place? It's the place where the public stakeholder, we believe, has to have a different engagement in terms to put a more ecosystem approach in the area, and in terms to feel and to support all necessary missed or gaps in the system, and to build it, let's say, in the better shape, or even to build a new model for this R&I ecosystem. It is not a single approach. It's not a single action that we are taking now, and especially that we are taking by RRF plan. It's a part of the reform efforts we started almost a year and a half ago, realizing that the economic transformation of the country, it's mostly possible by putting R&I transformation at the core. So we having to fill, and we have started to fill these gaps first by putting the public shareholder or stakeholder engagement, by creating a new state-owned agency, which is directly is going to be responsible for the policy of R&I and be a main integrator of all the public policies and the link between the industry, education, and the science. In this respect, we have started to elaborate on the national act national legislation, a new act for the research and innovation, which is going to bring players' roles and going to define some of the key processes which are still not better defined in the country, means the technology transfer, the IPR process, which are essential for this ecosystem to work. And we are also going part of this reform efforts to put a new fuel and a new relations in the research and business collaboration, which also we believe it's a quite essential. That's key efforts. We call it the mainstream of the reform, and all of them, you see, they are working for the improving the demand and supply in this ecosystem, which is unfortunately unbalanced in Bulgaria for the moment. So what we are going and what we are doing now within the RRF plan, RRF facility mechanism, is to tackle and to put investment in some of the building blocks of this system. Of course, we cannot solve all this problem with the recovery and resilience facility, but we decided to put some specific efforts regarding also the specificity of the plan. We have to have a measurable project. We have to have a real project with the concrete short-term leading to resilience. So that's why we decide to put an effort on first building some proper environment for innovation, for digitalization, and for STEM skills in the school, university, and for the adults, which is a broad project resulting in something like 1.5 billion lever. So this is one of the building block we believe was going to put in the foundation. The second one, building block, is the program for economic transformation through R&I. In this program, we have putting on key interventions, first to create a new model for research university, the new model which is going to put them on the international level with the independent evaluation, and also to give the future of R&I ecosystem to have this powerful source of new brains, new capacity, and mostly the link with the commercialization of the result of this system. So we are putting like a 320 million lever for building the very good foundation of this research university. And the last building block in this foundation is to transform in the certain level the Bulgarian Academy of Science capacity to the innovation institutions, innovation units, with a stronger linkage with industry. So probably you may know or not, Bulgarian Academy of Science is still delivering more than 70% of the supply of the research in the country, and we have to put a particular efforts to help these structures to deliver more and to having, let's say, proper balance with the demand of the business for the research, for commercialization.
Okay, that's great.
So in the very brief, that's what I would like to mention now, and ready
Excellent.
To answer for the question.